Dominican is 125 years old, with an even longer history that we are only beginning to uncover. And not all of our history is what we think it is. There are stories, legends on campus of a gruesome past that still lingers today. One of these stories is one of shame, secrets, and a little boy, the Blue Boy.
Everyone knows the story of Blue Boy.
Dominican's haunted.
Okay. So, a long time ago, before Medellin's was the current Medellin's, it was the old Medellin's. When it was the old Medellin's, there used to be a family that lived there. I believe it was the young, but I could be wrong. And on the third floor, there was a bathtub. And the nanny was there with the kids one day. And the kid was just playing in the bathtub. And the next thing you know, the nanny went up to check on the kid, and the kid was alone in the bathtub, the kid was drowned.
Legend has it that he had disabilities, and he was kept hidden away in the attic. They had a nanny who would take care of him, but the nanny was kind of off. The story is that one night, the nanny couldn't get Blue Boy to go to bed. So while he was taking a bath, the nanny decided, you know what, I'm going to strangle him, just because she was having so much trouble with him.
The nanny of Blue Boy and his sister drew the younger brother a bath and then put him in the bath, and then he ended up drowning. And the nanny, when she found out, was so distraught that she hung herself.
10 years ago, I used to live on campus, and I used to live in Meadowlands. And my room was referred to as the Blue Boy room. The legend itself, though, has been around for longer than I've been around. The legend goes that Blue Boy was a young child of the DeYoung family who used to own Meadowlands. It was their summer home. And he was specially disabled, and so they kept him away from, you know, the public eye. Back then in the 1800s, it just, you know, wasn't a thing. Basically, one day the nanny was taking care of Blue Boy upstairs in the attic, in where they kept Blue Boy. And the nanny either went crazy because Blue Boy was so difficult to deal with, or she just couldn't take it anymore and drowned him. And that's where Blue Boy came from. And he decided to haunt Dominican, Meadowlands especially, for as long as students have been around.
It was all about Blue Boy, the little Blue Boy that drowned.
So, is Blue Boy real? According to the Dominican archives, Meadowlands was built in 1888 for Michael H. DeYoung and his family as a vacation home. Michael and his brother Charles had founded the San Francisco Chronicle in 1865 and had become a force to be reckoned with. So, who is Blue Boy? In accordance with student legend, Annie Reed, the Dominican archivist, believes that it was Michael and Charles's youngest brother. However, the San Francisco Bay Guardian newspaper in 1984 published a DeYoung family tree, and it had no record of a younger brother. This is where things began to get a little weird. Digging deeper, I found a pattern of violent deaths among the men in the DeYoung family. After a slanderous and bloody conflict with Isaac Kallock, a preacher and mayoral candidate, Charles DeYoung was shot and killed. Years later, an enraged reader shot and killed Michael himself in the front of the Chronicle building. Also, out of Michael's 5 children, he had 1 son, Charles, named after his uncle, who died unexpectedly in a fishing accident. All 3 of the DeYoung men had died violent early deaths. Could this be the ghost of the forgotten and neglected DeYoung brother? Is there a DeYoung curse? Alumni, students, and faculty alike still feel the presence of Blue Boy today.
I work in the cafeteria, so the construction workers that were building Meadowlands would come in a couple times. You know, I'd sit down with them, eat with them, talk about like what's going on. And one time, one of the construction workers told me that they put the bathtub that supposedly Blue Boy drowned in on the top level, and they flipped it upside down and put chains on it. You know, to keep it there. They don't need it. They need it to be out of the way. And they go up there, and sometimes there'd be water underneath it and creep them out. They're like, it's not connected to anything. They chained it. They flipped it upside down. So they were always sketched out the fact that there was water, and they're like, what's going on? Blue Boy must be real.
My biggest experience from Blue Boy, living in Blue Boy's room, was my roommate and I had gone to Penguin Ball, and we were gone the entire night having fun. When we came back around midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning, we were coming up the stairs and we saw a group of nursing students outside of our dorm. They were like, Adolfo, what are you doing here? My roommate and I looked at each other and like, oh, we're just coming home. We were at Penguin Ball. And she said, that's weird. We thought you guys were inside your room because the TV had turned on about an hour ago and the volume had been getting louder and louder. And we were like, no, we've been gone all night. So sure enough, we could hear the TV blasting at this point.
So the first day, me and my roommate Blake moved in. We both moved our stuff in, and the bathroom door was open into Meadowlands. And as we got in there the first time, everything was good. We moved in, we had all our stuff in, we walked out, came back in probably like 2 hours later, and the bathroom door was locked. So we thought that our suite mates had moved in and that they had just either locked it by accident or just forgot to unlock it. So then we left again, and we came back in probably later at night, like around 10, and it was still locked. So then we called security because we needed to get in our bathroom and to shower and stuff. And security came through and they unlocked the other door that was next to us, and nobody had moved in yet. So the door just sort of like unlocked by itself, or locked by itself, and we didn't know how or why it happened. So maybe it was Blue Boy. We don't know.
There used to be a creek right next to my bed, and I vividly remember this creek. It's where you would step, and I always try to avoid it because it's really loud, and it only creaks when you step, you put your full weight on it. It's right next to my bed, so every morning I would try to avoid it, but I usually wouldn't and would wake up my roommate. It creaked. There was someone in my room. We immediately turned on all the lights and looked in, and there was nothing.
She lived in Meadowlands, and she had like this stuffed penguin that she always slept with. And so she one night she slept with it and woke up completely naked, butt naked. And she saw her penguin in the corner of her bed.
Oh my god.
Sitting on top of her clothes, perfectly folded, looking at her.
Dang.
In the corner of her bed.
Dang.
What?
Yeah.
Hi, my name is Lou Sweeney. I'm a nursing faculty here at Dominican. This is my office in the attic of the Meadowlands building. And just of interest is sometimes when I'm here very late at night, all by myself. I have a nice closet, which is an attic-like closet. And occasionally it sounds like there's action going on over there. Now I know old buildings talk, and the creaking and the groaning, but sometimes it's just a little bit creepy.
Everyone has their own stories, experiences, and beliefs. The question is, do you believe in Blue Boy?